Recorded Books presents Sea Wolves, Keepers of the Rainforest, written by Megan Benedict and Melanie Crowder, art by Roy Henry Vickers, read by Christina Moore. In a wrinkle of the rugged coast where the forest drops into the sea, a quiet cove holds secrets for those who look close, wade in, breathe deep. Waves spill over tangled kelp and discarded shells, fill a trail of paw prints, tiny wells that sift and still the water. The hunt has moved on. Claw pricks fade, one more wave, and all trace will be gone. Gray skies drip rain into steel gray sea. Plink, plink. Drops sink into thick fur, damp and matted with salt. Rippling bodies slide between tides, paddle across inlets, wavelets, braving murky depths and lurking swimmers far below. The strong ones know they must bring enough home. On the distant shore, wet snouts explore tide pools in full bloom. Nestled in rocks, the color of fur, the color of sky and sea, clams are wrenched free, cracked with sharp teeth. Slurp, smack, a salty snack, then retreat before the tide comes back. Beyond the bay, the river awaits a tumble of scales and shimmering tails. Plunge, snap, a mouthful of pink meat, tasty dinner treat. They slip ashore and back once more along the forest floor, overgrown green and moss soft. Hackles lift, ears prick, tick toward the roar, whirr, crunch of beastly metal saws and crushing steely claws. Rumble throat worry, silent slink hurry. A howl lifts delicate leaves, circles crumpled trees and blunted trunks, rises over the cacophony, calling the roaming distant ones, singing the pack home. Red-tipped ghosts lope through a sea of ferns, circle well-worn turns into the thick of the woods. Beneath a twisted cedar root, shadows shift, ears lift. Pups tumble out, all wet snout hellos and hungry belly yips. Soon, they will be the hunters, the sleek river runners, open water seekers, sacred keepers of the rainforest. From Megan Benedict and Melanie Crowder. Not Your Average Wolf. When you think of wolves, what do you see? You probably don't imagine beachcombers, tide pool foragers, or wet-eared swimmers paddling between islands, but the sea wolves of western Canada and southeastern Alaska are exactly that. These wolves are often smaller and tend to have shorter, coarser, red-tinted fur compared to interior wolves. Though scientists are just beginning to learn about this amazing coastal form of the gray wolf family, indigenous peoples have long known of their unique way of life and respected their vital roles in the ecosystem. They eat seafood. Living the island life has changed more than just their fur. While sea wolves do eat deer, like their inland cousins, they often pick seafood instead. They scavenge beached whales, hunt seals, and swipe salmon from rivers. When the tide is low, it's a buffet. They slurp fish eggs from kelp fronds, gnaw on mussels and barnacles, pry open clams, and catch skittering crabs. They swim. If you're picturing a dog paddle, you're not far off. When sea wolves swim between islands, only their heads are visible above the water, because so much of their diet is... Thank you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.